Cobra effect. How incentives that are designed to solve a problem end up making the problem further worse. And this is something that is explained by Cobra effect, a very commonly heard term in management, but we'll see how it is very much applicable to your studies and how can there be unseen consequences that actually come when there is a Cobra effect. So let's begin our journey with a very simple story of a kingdom where there were lots and lots of snakes that were seen around. So the people of the kingdom got very much puzzled about this problem of the snake. They were not aware about the problem and how to actually deal with the problem. So one man thought of taking this problem to the king's palace and get some resolution for it. So one fine day, he moved to the king's palace and said that we have a lot of problems about the growing population of the snakes in our kingdom and something needs to be done. So king thought of a great idea, and the idea was pretty simple. Bring the snakes to the king's palace and you would be rewarded for the same. So this was the thing that spread like wildfire in whole of the kingdom, and people started to immediately go and hunt for the snakes. Now as this people started to hunt for the snake, definitely the population on one side was going down, but on the other side the kingdom was giving them great amounts, great rewards, and this pleased the people and they thought this is a nice way of making money, definitely. So what they did was, the population of the snakes that was there, as you could see, started to decline all of the sudden. So the number of snakes that were there in the kingdom started to decrease and the king was very, very happy. But one man thought of an idea. The idea was, this is a good way to earn a money. So what we can do is, we can have some snakes in our home. We can just do a kind of thing where we can rear snakes, and this would be a good way to earn the money. So the person started to basically have more and more snakes, do the breeding for the snakes, and ultimately what happened was, the king realized that there was something wrong going on in the kingdom and said, from today onwards there would be no more rewards for any snakes that would be brought to the kingdom. As a result, the people who were actually rearing and breeding the snakes thought that, what to do, we have now so many snakes. So they said, these snakes are no more useful to us, so why not leave them in the kingdom again. And the problem reached the same place where it started. So the kingdom again now has several snakes. How to deal with a situation like this is what is explained under the Cobra effect. So here we could see the population of snakes, which was to be controlled, kept on growing despite of the efforts that were brought about. We have same examples from our daily life. Let's say if a person gets obese and a doctor recommends to do a little of exercise, that would be a good way of reducing the obesity. So what happens is, the person brings in a treadmill. The idea of treadmill actually gets into a momentum and the person starts to walk on the treadmill. With days of walking, the person actually goes thinner and thinner and thinner. But now he realizes, I am fit enough. So why not have certain more recreation? So what he does is, he just sits down on a treadmill, moving his leg and feeling that he is doing a treadmill. And ultimately what happens is, his old situation back again, where he thinks, why I am back to my obesity. And this happens with us on a day-to-day life patterns, life activities that we see. And definitely in education, this is something that happens very often. So we have two simple examples to help you understand. There was a student who secured very good in all of the examinations. So what happened was the parents got very happy and brought the girl a laptop. Now, as soon as the laptop came in, all the recreation started. So there were video games, there were games that were being played, and ultimately the result went down. This brought in a kind of shock to the student, and she started to work hard again and finally secured the position back. So there is where we have the effect that could be seen, but this effect is not just if you are actually performing good in your studies. The same effect applies if you are not performing well in the study. So what happened was there was a student who did not actually perform good in the studies. So there was a constant drive to do good, and as a result he started reading lots of books, got good books, good material, and secured good. But once he secured good, there was overconfidence that came in, and this brought him back to his previous situation where he started playing on the laptops again, playing on the computer games again, and reduced the score. So this is again an example where the things can actually get worse. So what we need to understand is maintaining consistency in whatever you do. When you are seeking for incentives, seeking for solutions, make sure that those solutions will not lead to a further worse situation as it was in the beginning. So be very, very particular for whatever steps you take for your improvement. Maintain a consistent behavior, and that consistency is something that would actually lead you with good results. We'll see you soon with many more interesting motivational lectures. Have a wonderful day ahead.